video, I'm going to talk about my June TBR. First of all, I want to start with the books that I'm currently reading. The first book that I'm going to talk about is a book that you have seen many times. The whole stories of Sherlock Holmes, written in Turkish. This tome contains all of the short stories of Sherlock Holmes. I have been reading 10 stories per month from the beginning of the year. And this book contains 56 stories. So I will be finishing this book certainly in June. This is the last time that you are going to see this book on my TBR. But after finishing this book, beginning from July, we will buddy read the Sherlock Holmes novels that is written by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle with by Naomi from Naomi's bookshelf. My Sherlock Holmes journey will continue with the novels. Second book that I'm currently reading is an audiobook, Crime and Punishment by Fyodor Dostoyevsky. As I mentioned in my May TBR, because I'm not going to work every day like in the usual times, and I listen to the audiobooks while I'm going to work, my progress has been really slow, and Crime and Punishment is also a very thick book, as you all know. I'm not really sure if I will be finishing this classic in the month of June. So far, I'm liking the book, but not loving it, because it goes through so many details. His writing style is very interesting, but it goes out of the main story so much. Sometimes I lose my attention and have to listen to some sections again. So it's going slow, but as I've said before, it's a fine book for me. I hope it will have a better tempo in the later sections of the book. For the books that I'm going to start in June, the first book is The Illumination of Ursula Flight by Anne-Marie Crowhurst, I'm going to body read this book with Veronica from We Reads and Rambles. She currently took a break from BookTube. Because of this pandemic, we connected again to check out how we were doing, and we decided to body read a book together again, because we had a fantastic body reading experience when we were reading Bear Town by Frederick Bachman. And I cannot wait to buddy read this historical fiction book with Veronica again. The next two books that I'm going to talk about are also historical fiction books. And they are the books that we are going to read for my real life book club. The first one is Black Tulip by Alexandre Dumas. I chose this for my book club because I previously read The Count of Monte Cristo by Alexandre Dumas, and I was surprised by how engaging the story was for a classic, because unfortunately in classics the stories are rarely engaging. And I have this book in iPad library application. I wanted my friends to experience Alexandre Dumas as well. The second book that we are going to talk about is a Turkish book, Emanet Zaman by Defne Suman. And Emanet Zaman can be translated as Trusted Time. The story takes place in three different timelines. One in 1909, one in at the beginning of the Turkish Independence War in 1919, and one in 1926, few years after the war. These stories took all place in Izmir, my hometown in Turkey. So I'm really eager to read this book. And the next four books are all part of my Stacking the Series challenge. The first book is The Other Queen by Phillippa Gregory. This is the last book in the series. And I'm really happy that I finished this 15 book series, Plantagenet and Tudor Queen series by Philippa Gregory. The Other Queen tells the story of Queen Mary of Scots. I think it will be a good book to finish the series. The next stack in the series challenge book is Anne of Ingleside by Ellen Montgomery. This is the next book in Anne of Green Gables series that I'm participating in Anne Along Read Along to Anne Along to 2020 that is co-hosted by Amanda from the Curly Reader and Tia from Tia and All the Books. So far, I've enjoyed all of the books that I've read, some less, some a bit more, from Anne of Green Gables series. And Anne is one of my favorite characters in literature, so it's always a delight to go back to Anne's world, even if the books are not as good as the first one. The next book on my Stacking the Series challenge is a series that I'm going to restart. What I mean by restart is that I have read the previous two books almost 2 years ago and really loved them. It's a small town contemporary romance series, Blue Heron series by Kristan Higgins, and the next book on that series is Waiting on You. I will also read this book for Summer Romance Book Bingo, which I will post a separate TBR in June. I like reading romance books in summer, so that's why I waited until June to read this book. I'm sure this contemporary small-town romance novel will be cozy and fill my heart with very romantic feelings. The last Stacking the Series challenge book has not been a part of Stacking the Series. I previously DNF'd the category 2 series that I was going to, that I was originally going to read in 2020. So I decided to put two books from a series that I'm reading anyway. So I decided to put Locke and Key, written by Joe Hill and illustrated by Gabriel Rodriguez. Volumes 5 and 6 in that challenge, so that it will fit the general theme of both reading two books and also finishing the series. Because in my yearly goal, I looked for a series that will be finished when I finished the Stacking the Series challenge as well. The Locke and Key graphic novel series is about three siblings who are trying to find the keys to doors that leads to very different and supernatural occurrences in their family mansion, Locke Mansion. Although it's a horror graphic novel, it's not overly gory, but it's very engaging. I really enjoyed what I read so far. So I cannot wait to read the last two volumes and finish the series. And the last book that I'm going to talk about is another installment of a graphic novel series, Back to the Future Volume 2. I previously read the first volume in May and really enjoyed reading it. And this volume called Continuum, Conundrum, Marty McFly in 1985 receives a letter from Clara that says that Dr. Brown is lost in 1893, and Marty probably goes back to the past to find where Dr. Brown is. Those are the books that I plan to read for June. Please comment down below if you have read any of these books and what did you think about them. And if you are a new viewer, please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish Word of the Day, since this video is about June TBR, I thought June should be the word of the day. June means Haziran in Turkish, and Haziran is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!